In my last video, linked in the description, I tried to pair the footages coming from a Canon EOS M with those coming from a Pocket 4K. Let's see my very easy and basic workflow. We can achieve our goal in different ways, through a managed color space or an unmanaged color space. This time, I'll use DaVinci YRGB non-managed color space. My output color space as Rec. 709A, because I'm a Mac user and my display is directly connected via USB-C to my Mac. As timeline color space, DaVinci White Gamut, because I want to work in a large color space and I want to take advantage of all the tools which DaVinci offered to work in the timeline before of the final output color space. So, we have here the EOS M clip and the Pocket 4K clip. The EOS M clip was shot in 2.35 aspect ratio, so I set the project with that resolution and cropped the Pocket 4K clip. In my first node of the Pocket clip, which we label as color space transform in, I will set a color space transform. The input color space is Blackmagic White Gamut Gen 4.5. Input gamma Blackmagic Film Gen 5. And instead of sending it to Rec. 709, I'll put it in DaVinci White Gamma, which is a bigger color space than the one of the Blackmagic, and it's a very good intermediate color space where we can mix different camera formats. I'll do the same in my EOS M clip, but this time, because the EOS M clip is raw and it doesn't have a default color space, we can choose one as starting point for further correction. I'll set it as a standard sRGB and send it again to DaVinci White Gamut color space and DaVinci Intermediate Gamma. Then I'll set my tone mapping method to none. After that, we have to go out from DaVinci White color space and enter into Rec. 709. So I'll create a CST out node at the timeline level because the space transform will be applied to both cameras. We come from DaVinci White Gamut, so input color space DaVinci White Gamut, input gamma DaVinci Intermediate, output color space Rec. 709. Output gamma Rec. 709A, same of our project. Pocket 4K, Canon EOS M. So, let's go back to the clip level. For this tutorial, I'm going to create 4 basic serial nodes. One for the expose, one for the contrast, one for the balance, and one for the saturation before of our CST out node. Now, I'm going to grab a still of the Pocket 4K clip as reference to match as well as possible the EOS M clip. Right-click on the image, grab still, and for best results, I'll use the scope as guide. Clicking on the image wipe, I'll split my viewer between the still from the Pocket 4K and my EOS M clip. As you can see, the same happens in my scopes. So, be sure to select Display Qualifier Focus in your scopes, Qualifier in your viewer, and positioning it in a spot of the image where you want to align the two exposure. In this case, I will choose the face and, as you can see in the waveform, the EOS M stay to around 250 nits and the Pocket 4K near 500 nits. I like to work with my HDR wheels, but you can use primary wheels or curve to reach the same result. So, in my exposure node, I raise the global exposure in my HDR wheels, always taking a look at the waveform. Then, I add some contrast using my primaries. Adjusting a little bit the pivot. So, moving to the balance node. I'll try to balance the colors of the two clips. In my global wheel, I put some green. Remember, I'm working on the M clip on the left of the viewer, trying to pair it to the Pocket 4K. Then, in my log wheels, I add some red in the shadow and lower some blue. I push some magenta using the tint tool. Now I'm going to my saturation node to add some sat to the clip. Go back to the exposure node because now I want to set the correct face luminance and I check the scope to align the waveform. I raise the shadow and lower the dark parts of the image. Now my mid-tones are aligned, but I need to add a little bit of contrast and lowering some light. So in my logs, I lower the shadow just a little bit. In my HDR, I lower the light. So now let's align our highlights. Here is our reference and we have to align the difference of luminosity. So let's jump to our exposure node, HDR wheels. First, I raise the light. And then lower the highlight. Now the two waveforms are well aligned. Let's turn off the image wipe. So we put the EOSM in a good starting point and similar to the Pocket 4K. Now we can refine the two clips at the timeline level and this adjustment will be applied to both clips. I'm going to create three adjustment nodes before of our CST out node. Post exposure, post contrast, and post balance. In the post exposure node, I lower the global exposure just a little bit. In my post contrast node, I lower the shadow in my log wheels. And in my post balance node, I'll move my temperature towards a cool tone. Okay, much better. Pocket 4K, USM. Now we can also change our color space if we want to apply some LUT. We can do that in the CST out node. For example, if you want to use the Kodak LUTs included in DaVinci, we have to change our output gamma from Rec 709 to Cineon. Then add a serial node after the CST node. And choose under the LUT tab, Film Looks, and I choose the Kodak 2383D60. Pocket 4K, USM, very similar. So let's check out our skin tone. I'll put the qualifier on the skin and we can see in the scopes we are just on the skin tone line. Let's try now the Phantom LUTs for the Blackmagic Pocket 4K. We set node. Again, we have to change the output to color space and gamma in the CST node. Output color space Blackmagic Gen 5, output gamma Blackmagic Film Gen 5. Under the LUT tab, search for the Phantom LUT Film Pack Gen 5. Eastman Kodak Film. I label the node as LUT. Pocket 4K, USM. Finally, I will add some noise reduction and sharpness to the USM and some grain to both clips. I put the noise reduction node at the beginning of my node tree. So let's zoom a little bit to see the change. In temporal noise reduction, as frame I choose 3, then better, and temporal threshold 6. Reds are more clean now. Then I'll add another node at the end of the node tree for sharpness. Go to the blur tool and set the radius to 47. And finally, at the timeline level after my LUT node, I'll create a grain node. So, search for grain. Under presets, I choose 35 mm. Zoom a little bit, trying to see the grain. I change the grain size to 0.25, grain strength 0.35, softness 0.25. Okay, it's all, we are done. Thanks for your time, and let's see the final result.